Hi everyone, welcome to my fresh channel Med Media, where I will try to combine my two interests of life, films and medicine. Maybe you also find yourself in this situation where watching a movie, you stop for a minute and think, is it even possible? Or would the person certainly be dead after that fall? Since I catch myself thinking about it quite enough, I, as a fourth year medical student, feel comfortable enough to lead my viewers through the world of the human body, trying to talk about it as simple as possible, and help people to find answers to these questions. A couple of days ago, I watched a 2014 movie Horns, where our beloved boy Harry Potter got chilled south and packed with Slytherin team. Daniel Radcliffe grows horns and causes chaos among other citizens of a town. From the minute I saw those few tiny little horns on Daniel's head, I was distracted by them. They keep me thinking, can humans grow horns in real life? This is the question we're trying to answer in this video. Once again, welcome to Med Media. In today's video, I will try to break down medical stuff behind having a real horns. To find the answer to this question, we have to find a couple of things first. We have to understand what is a horn, from what materials horns are made of. Do humans have this material in our own body? Let's start with the easiest one. What is a horn? To answer this question, we have to dig into the world of the two most fundamental branches of medicine, anatomy and histology. This is the interesting fact about horns. Horns, despite growing and changing shapes, are not considered a living tissue. There is no nerves in them and they do not bleed when they are fractured. So basically, and according to research, horns are composed of a short bony core covered with skin. The skin covering the bony core is composed of epidermis that generates new cells to grow and eventually becomes a body of a horn. Despite horns having a bone core, they are much different from them. You may ask how it can be different, since it definitely looks like it and it often feels like it. Unlike other structural biomaterials such as bone, teeth or even mollusk shell, horns does not have a mineralized component. Every tissue of a human body are composed of two things, cells and extracellular matrix. It is a surrounding structure around every cell which connects all cells to one tissue. For example, human bones are so strong because bone cells are binding with the inorganic mineral salts such as calcium phosphate. This structure gives bones rigidity and hardness. According to a research published in 2009, bones do not have a mineralized component and is composed mostly of alpha keratin. Interestingly enough, alpha keratin is a protein found in every vertebrate such as sharks, frogs, rabbits and other 55,000 living species, which includes us humans as well. But where is this material in our body? As we all know, all humans have skin, unless you are living in the wonderful world of Game of Thrones and you are caught by Ramsay Bolton and his lovely family.
In my family we say, a naked man has few secrets, a flayed man none.
Those who do not know, skin is the largest organ of the body and makes about 60% of human body mass. Skin's main function is to protect us from the dangerous environment. Because of that, it has a very complex structure. Many of us already know that skin has three different layers. The inner layer is the hypoderm,
also known as subcutaneous tissue, which sits above the muscles. Very important layer is the middle one, called dermis. This layer contains sweat glands and hair follicles, nerves and blood vessels, and has many other important structures. The outer layer of the skin is epidermis, and today this is the layer we are interested in, since epidermis has five layers of its own, and most layers are composed of cells called keratinocytes, which produces this protein.
So what did alpha-keratin actually do and why it exists in our body? Being protein, alpha-keratin is used as the building blocks in our body. In the skin, it forms a strong layer which forms a wall to protect the body against microbial pathogens, ultraviolet light, and provides mechanical resistance to minor injuries. Keratin is mostly found in human hairs and nails, just like horns in animals. As I more think about it, horns are just a huge nails in every strange and unusual part of a body. At this point of a video, we all can assume that, theoretically, if we manage to make keratinocytes divide and grow, it is possible to grow a horn from the skin. However, is it really possible in our normal human world? The simple answer is yes. We have plenty of stories and photos throughout the internet that proves it, but this is not a thing that everybody will want since it's a disease and a serious one. In Latin, this disease is called cornus cutaneum or cutaneous horn in English. Sadly enough, this is keratinous skin tumor. In our body cell, life is going in a cycle. When one cell gets older and damaged, they die and new cells take their place. This is called the cell life cycle. Patient cells who have cancer do not die. They multiply and grow faster, forming new tissue. In our case, a horn.
This condition is rare and causes are still unknown. Some believe that exposure to sunlight or viruses such as papillomavirus can cause it.
The treatment can be different on form and one person to person and depends on the part of the body horns grow, since it can grow everywhere around the body there is a layer of skin. However, the most common treatment composed of surgical removing the tumor, and if the horn is cancerous, it may require chemotherapy or radiation therapy. In the movie, it was shown that the horn grows overnight and grows fast every day. To grow such long horn, it will require years and maybe even decades. And no magic or mystical power is needed, only a science and bad luck. Nobody would like to have this intentionally, since cancer is a very serious and dangerous disease which requires a difficult treatment. So, after all, if you like this video and want to see more content where I break down medical stuff behind the movies, please leave a like and hit that subscribe button. Help our channel grow by writing a comment. If you have a suggestion or advice, please write us an email. This was MedMedia. Hope you like this video.